close to our domains. Planted rich and rotten chains.
Might we speak?
Yeah? What is it?
Now, why does one summon a witcher, hmm? To inquire about the gossip currently flowing about the court? I have a problem with a beast.
Ah, you the one posted the notice? Go on then, spit it out. What's it about?
First, my dear witcher, we must establish ground rules. Given the vast difference in our respective social positions, I'm sorry to say I take umbrage at the familiar tone you take. I expect deference. I expect you to address me as Sir, or better yet, as Monsieur de Bobo.
Listen, friend. There's an enormous difference between us, but it's not about status. It's about me having two swords on my back, and you having none. So I'll call you whatever I want, and you either deal with that or solve your monster problem yourself.
The gall. I shall file a complaint with your guild.
Mm-hmm. Make sure you address it to customer service. Care Morin, Kedwin. Now talk, before I change my mind and go.
Nordlings and their manners. Very well. Let us get this over with. Something has infested my vineyard.
Mm-hmm. Great. Let me go prepare my something oil then.
I beg your pardon?
Need more information than that. Where was this something seen? Any witnesses? Bodies to examine?
Therein lies the rub. None has seen the beast. We've only heard signs of its presence, a strange scratching and shrieks. Neither are there any corpses to inspect. Men simply disappear without a trace.
Who's disappeared, if you don't mind my asking?
Most recently some farmhand, I believe.
Despite the vast difference in social status, you remember the farmhand's name, maybe?
No. You must speak to my wife. She has more collegial relations with this household help. She's away at the moment visiting her mother, but should return forthwith.
Noises you mentioned. Where do they come from?
Well, everywhere. But they're most clearly audible in the wine cellar.
Means the monster must dwell underground. When are the noises loudest?
In the night, just as they were years ago, when the buildings quaked. Another expert agreed to look into the matter then, but was never thereafter seen nor heard of. Oh, that should suffice with the questions. Now tell me, will you take the contract, yea or nay?
Depends. What kind of reward are we talking about?
Fine. Seems I must take the loss. Agreed.
Fine, I'll do it. Need to look around here first. Then I'll want to talk to Madame de Bourbeau.
Very well. I shall inform you once she has returned. Meanwhile, the key to the cellar. Just, whatever you do, please do not disturb the wine barrels.
Not even a draft horse will talk without some carrot to move it.
Go up to any knight and shout, "The beast!" You'll smell the soiled armor at once.
It's quiet. Guess the monster actually is nocturnal. Gotta wait till dark. All right, let's look around. Shattered dishes. Got knocked off the shelf somehow. Shaken off, maybe? Rats. Not known to kidnap foremans.
Thank you.
Destroy them before the young hatch. Start prowling the vineyard. Now Kikimor dug this. Tunnels are the work of something much bigger. Something with heavy, wide claws. Shaelmaar dug this. Tunnels are the work of something much bigger. Something with heavy, wide claws. Underground, digs tunnels, feeds on Kikimors, and is big. Very big. Won't learn anything else here. Time to go back to the surface.
Sacrebleu!
What is the meaning of this? I'm paying you to slay a monster, not demolish my property!
Property's falling apart on its own, what with all the tunnels under it. I'd fill those in soon if you don't want your building to collapse.
Tunnels? Fiddle, my farm! How did tunnels appear down there?
Something dug them. A large creature. Also killed a few Kikimors down there and destroyed their eggs. Consider it a half favor. Won't cost you much.
Kikimor eggs? Yes, of course. Good work. Indeed, a reward is due.
Madame de Bourbeau, I presume? Hear you know something about the missing farmhand.
Jean-Luc? Yes. We went to examine this year's seedlings. Something had been nibbling at them. Then we heard these odd noises. Jean-Luc went to reconnoiter, and never returned.
Where did you last see Jean-Luc, madame? Exactly.
In the fields, north of here, by the wood.
New seedlings there? I was under the distinct impression we had planted them all on the south slope.
Almost all, my dear. I requested that some be planted to the north. By the grove. Just the remainders.
Madame, could you describe Jean-Luc?
Tall, exceedingly well built, hair black as pitch.
Dear, concentrate. There is not a peasant that is not well built. They work in the fields all day. He means scars, birthmarks, that sort of thing.
Then none, I suppose, but... He did wear a pendant around his neck. A silver one.
Silver jewelry? On a farmhand?
It was a gift, I believe. Or that is what he claimed.
Should be enough to go on.
Then what are you fritting round here for? Get to work!
Perhaps I can turn these tunnels into an extended cellar.
Let's go!
I never knew vampire exterminations could be so hard. I've worked up my plan.
Bread's really stale. Been here a while. Blanket was laid out here. Footprints. Two sets. Tracks split. Woman turned back here. Man kept going. Man's footprints lead here. Blood. Human. Shell. Large, deep tracks. Claw marks. Straight, dull, perfect for digging. Felled trees, as if something rolled over them. So is Shaelmaar. Only they dig tunnels and move like that. To that cave. surface. Straight, dull, perfect for digging. Shaelmaar's lair, gotta be. Drags its victims here. Pretty fresh, some of them. Gonna have to brew some bait. Need the blood of a recent victim, and some of the mushrooms that grow here. Fresh corpse. Must be Jean-Luc. Crushed ribs, cracked skull. Shaelmaar did this, no two ways about it. Highly decayed, partly eaten. Been lying here a while. Silver pendant. A lock of hair inside. Same color as Madame de Bourbeau's. Throughout the cave. Ugh, that stench. Thank you.
Mahakam.
A hero, Geralt's dream.
Death shall weigh on your conscience, butcher.
The wall. Fix it by the end of the day.
You. Can we talk?
You'd best be bearing good news. Get on with it.
Got rid of the beast that was giving you trouble. It was a Shaelmaar.
Shaelmaar? Whatever could that be?
Kinda like a cross between a mole and a caterpillar. Just big as a barn.
Huh? Well, Master Witcher, you make a poor first impression, but ultimately proved your worth. There. Your reward.
As for Jean-Luc, afraid he's dead. Sorry.
Who? Oh, him. Trivial as losses go. I shall soon find another to take his place.
Right. After all, he is just a peasant. Not a monsieur de blah blue blah. So long.
Folks say some large armor. It's one.